We're back. Just got time to squeeze a small, quick one in for you before Christmas. Watercolours, no gouache this time, and I'm going to use my tablet watercolour rather than the tubes this time as well. Because I'm going to try and do it quite fast so I can show you more real-time stuff rather than the speeded up stuff. So let's get on with it. Thanks very much. Okay, so I'm sat down. I've done most of the work as I said I was going to do. Or did I? Well, I have. The usual, like I've shown you in the past couple of videos. Pencil, then acrylic wash. Getting the tonal values, basically, the shadows and stuff like that, and a little bit more information for myself, hopefully, to speed up the next process. And the next process is watercolour again, no gouache this time, so it's going to be transparent, nothing opaque. And I'm using the tablets rather than the tubes, just because I fancy doing that today. Brushes. These are just acrylic brushes, but I find they're decent for watercolour as well, those ones. But they're all good. I've also got watercolour brushes there as well, but I'll probably just stick to the one brush. And first thing, start mixing colours. It's going to be quite earthy colours in this, so to keep it easy for myself and because I like that. So I'll start with the first washes and layer up from there with other washes as we go along. I'll try to vocalize what I'm doing as much as I can, but sometimes I get sucked in and I forget there's even cameras looking at me. Anyway, let's go. Got my trusty sprayer. Keep everything moist. I don't like that word, moist. Just sounds moist. Yep, just getting everything wet and ready. And, let's go. So I'm going to start with a sort of medium brown, something like that sepia. Get that there ready. Get some orange in there as well ready. Okay, so I need to quickly warm things up. What's that? Alright. Sorry, you probably hear Sandy. He's not very professional. Actually, he's very professional. He's very good. I'm just trying to sort of second guess myself at the moment what colours I'm going to be using. But like most plans, it doesn't always work out that way. Right. I don't want to procrastinate too much. Need to dive in with something. My chihuahua, you might be able to hear that. She just came in with a stick. I don't know where she got it from. I So just putting on the first colours. I'll layer that up with warmer browns and colder browns in certain areas. Hopefully you'll be able to see when and where I do that. Example there, I'm just adding some warmer brown while it's still wet. Let it do its magic. Tend not to try and be too strict in the beginning by saying, oh, he's going to have a blue hat or whatever. I try to leave it till the very last minute and go on instinct. As I say, I'm going to keep this earthy and straightforward. So as you can see here, these are just the first layers of the brown. What I tend to do is quite methodical really. With the top parts or whatever's in the light, I tend to keep a warm brown, and anything else is cooler. And with the cooler stuff, I might add a little bit of blue or purple to the brown, which we'll see as I go along. These are the initial sort of layers to work on later. And now that I've done this, it's making me think of other potential colours rather than just browns, which is why I tend to leave things until this stage as far as colour goes, because instinct takes over and usually gets some nice decisions then. Not always, but usually. So yeah, case in point, I think I'm going to make his little neck scarf quite warm colour, maybe a yellowish. See, the good thing about getting a detailed drawing underneath it all, and plus the acrylic ink, is it means you can be quite sort of quick over the top and still not lose much information. And go back and tighten it later. Sandy kissing my chihuahua while I'm working. How dare he kiss my chihuahua? Of course, coffee is the other essential liquid. Right. So I'm going to carry on putting these first colours down on this character. In the meantime, I'm going to put some tunes on so I can concentrate. But I'll be back. Okay, so, as I said, I was doing the initial layers, the initial colours. I've gone back and sort of added a few other colours to that, but nothing substantial. But that's what I'm going to do now. I'm going to go back and do another layer of colour on certain areas before I carry on doing the base colours for these two. So. Don't want to smudge it. So with this satchel type thing, make it a bit warmer at the top, maybe a bit cooler down here, and use that same sort of thinking around the other areas. Just need to remember that watercolour dries quite pale compared to how you initially put it on. Same on the top of his hat. Slightly cooler browns, introduce a little bit of blue, see how that looks. notice now and then I'll do one area and then go somewhere else and use the... It's basically because I see the colour I put down and think, oh, that'll work okay over there. And I just try and do what I can when I can. The chihuahua, you can probably hear. Demanding attention. So yeah, that's turning out okay. I think I can afford to go a bit colder there. And even at this stage, that pencil we did earlier is working. Still working as a good guide for shadow, etc. Good thing about watercolour is now and then you can go back and sometimes remove it completely, but usually just knock a colour back if you need it to be pale again. I want to keep this quite warm, so I need to lighten it a bit if I can. Right, yeah, so I want to keep that warm, so I'll even add a bit of yellow. It might be too much, but we'll see. Yep, that's fine. Same principle applies for when painting flesh, the way I'm doing this. Warm colours where it's lit by the light, and a little bit of blue, or cooler colours where it's in shade. Right. I realise I've gone very quiet. Two faces are still nerve-wracking. Still working on the warmer areas of the face.
It's still too early.
Alright, I'm almost done with the cool shades on this first face. I'm quite happy with it. I'll cover it later and do what I normally do with the final shadows, the deeper shadows. Pick out certain details, but I think most of the information I need is down already. For him. So the reason it's been goblins I've been doing for the past few videos, and quite a lot on Instagram, is because I plan on releasing through someone else a small sort of book on these things next year. No details yet, but just letting you know. Stuff's on the way, and plus other stuff to do with this as well, possibly. I look forward to good news on that. But yeah, plus I like doing goblins. Yeah. Also, watercolour is not something I'm asked often to do by companies and stuff, so it's a nice opportunity to do that sort of thing. It takes a lot of concentration doing these parts, I'm afraid that's why I shut up for a bit. But, yeah, these are like the focal points we're working on here, so I'm not going to pay much more attention to this because I'm quite happy with it. But as we go up here, I need to tighten up a bit. So I'm just working up some more of the deeper shadows without going to the black just yet. Same principle again. Do the undercolours first, the first layer if you like. And build up slowly from there. Where you want it to be light or warm, try and leave the white of the paper as much as you can. People obviously ask me all the time where my ideas come from. I just say to myself, well, I fancy doing some goblins today, and I'll start doodling in thumbnails and shapes, and then like I've said in past videos, I just work those shapes up into bigger shapes, more shapes, until it starts telling me what to do. So it's mostly conscious, but it's like looking at clouds. You'll see stuff in there that other people won't see until you point it out. It's the same part of the brain, I think. Plus, I've done it loads, so you know, I could say, oh, I want to do a smiling goblin, and I can go away and do it. But obviously, when I first started as a youngster, that would have been more difficult. But then, you know, time, patience, keep doing it. That's the answer to everything, really. So these two are pretty much there. I'm going to go back and brighten up certain parts before I do the final shadows. But looking at it now, I don't think I'm going to do too much shadow work, but we'll see. I might change my mind. Onto this one now. Now I'm thinking how to balance it out. Got greens and yellows down here. He's pretty warm. So I could either get away with a cold colour or a warm colour on this part here. His hat. Over these parts with this guy, because he's in the background, I use purple rather than blue for the sort of shadowy areas out of habit more than anything, but it seems to work, seems to push things back nicely. I might carry it on over to him, but I don't know yet, but we'll see. It's a constant balancing act, really. But that's, you know, that's part of the fun, apparently. So I'm going for more than one colour. Yeah, I've made more work for myself there because I'm going to have to balance those colours with each other, but I'm glad I did. I think that'll be fine. Good tool to have around, trusty hairdryer if you're impatient like me. Can be quite methodical with watercolour, which helps. As watercolour is scary if you haven't used it before, but once you get used to it, and you get used to it by doing it a lot, so you know, have a go. Mustn't forget, this is a lot easier doing it this way simply because of the time spent on the drawing and the underwash.
Thank you.
So, hope you enjoyed that. I did. It was good fun. It was nice to have the chance to squeeze one in for you before the holidays. So, from me and Goblin, hope you have a good, whatever you're doing, Christmas. Or whatever you're into, have a good one. Have a good new year. And as Goblin's always telling me, all you need to remember is not to be a cunt. Cheers.